Congresswoman Ilhan Omar, she just head back to her district, just landed back home in Minnesota, and this is how she was greeted at the airport. Watch this.
Ilhan, welcome home, Ilhan! Welcome home, Ilhan!
Welcome home, Ilhan. Is that obviously supporters meeting her there? Instead of now, are you making her a hero? Is that what Donald Trump is doing with Ilhan Omar now?
Look, you know what? If you don't think that the squad knows what they're doing, they've been elevated to basically the
top. You don't have to say it with such disdain. I mean, we've had like the young guns. Everybody's got a name.
Yeah, and so we were just saying before, it's all about Donald Trump and terrible and this and that. Like, the 24 Democrats running are so virtuous, and they never say a bad thing.
No.
Are you kidding me?
No. You know what I am saying, though? Take people on policy. Take Ilhan Omar on policy.
Let them take him on policy.
They called him a fascist.
They called him a fascist.
She called him a fascist,
They've
sure.
called him you know everything
no, no, no,
in
no.
the name.
Listen,
but that's okay, because they're immune.
Donald Trump has a history of calling people everything in the book, first of all. He's called people racist as well. You were on here on Monday or Tuesday when we were on. You were saying if only the left would stop calling people racist, then this wouldn't happen. Well, you know what? Donald Trump called Barack Obama a racist. Donald Trump called Ture a racist. Donald Trump called Brent Gumbel a racist. He even called the movie Django Unchained racist. Donald Trump has a history of calling people racist. You don't have a problem when he does it.
You called Nancy Pelosi racist because she called him out as a
racist.
Exactly.
But if the moment somebody calls the racist a racist, suddenly it's a problem. Let's call a thing a thing. Donald Trump is a racist. Last night,
Donald Trump can do what he tells everyone he cannot.
I felt like I was watching a Klan rally last night, and Donald Trump was the grand imperial wizard leading people in a chant telling a black woman, a member of Congress, to go home to Africa. That is racist. That is textbook racism. It should be condemned from the halls of Congress to the White House to every person who comes on television and speaks as a political expert.
Some Republican lawmakers have and said that made them sick to their stomach. And that's not what I see from Donald Trump. And that's not what I'm hearing from you.
Well, what I said to Keith the other night, and it's clear, that if anyone supports Donald Trump or his presidency or his policies, and if they're going to vote for him because they can't stand any of the 24 Democrats, then they, by definition of the Democratic Party now, are racist. That's where we're at. That's exactly the nexus that has been drawn.
So you tell
63 million people watching right now, even those undecided, you're a racist, according to the Democrats.
I'll tell you one thing.
Of course I don't.
That's why I'm here. I'll tell you one final thing.
Last thought.
This is supposed to be the party of Lincoln. Abraham Lincoln would be turning over his grave right now to see what Donald Trump has done to this party and what the Republicans have allowed to happen to this party. Lincoln tried to...
What about JFK? What would he think of the Democratic Party
always
today?
Always trying to steal the subject and change the topic. Yeah. Lincoln tried to appeal to the better angels of our nature. This guy only appeals to the worst demons of our disposition. Well, it's unacceptable.
It is a fact that Donald Trump is playing on division and playing on negativity and playing on us versus them. There is no question about that. And what you say,
Rob knows it too. That's what's so sad.
Rob has told me a million times, though, that he wishes that the president would focus on the economy. That is not what he is doing. Let us see what happens tomorrow.